When I got into growing mushrooms, I wanted to make my life easier and automate my environment. I was quickly overwhelmed though by how many individual systems and monitors I would need, and I knew there had to be a better way. Welcome to the Felix Smart Studio. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you just how easy it is to automate mushroom growing with Kai, the Felix Smart Controller. This is actually the topic that introduced me to the Felix Smart team. I saw the immense potential for Kai for mushroom cultivation, and I knew I wanted to jump on board. So today we have some mushroom grow bag of blue oyster mushrooms from our friend Vicky at Basil Ranch, and we're gonna be setting this colonized grain spawn up in a grow tent and letting Kai do all the hard work. For this tent, I'm gonna set up lights. Most mushrooms like a light cycle of maybe anywhere from 10 to 18 hours of light a day, but it depends on the strain you're growing. I'm also gonna need a fresh air exchange with this fan here. Mushrooms breathe in oxygen just like humans do and opposite to plants. So they are putting out CO2 and need oxygen in. So you need to keep fresh air circulating, otherwise your mushrooms are gonna suffocate, like putting a plastic bag over your head or something like that. They also might grow with deformities if you have too high of CO2. And this fan is gonna help push spores out of the tent, so this is really important. And then we have a humidifier as well, because mushrooms really like a moist environment. So we're gonna keep humidity around maybe 70 to 90%. For us, it's gonna be higher because our oyster mushrooms like that high humidity. And then we also have a temperature and humidity sensor from Felix Smart. This will help give us a really good idea of what's going on in our tent without us having to eyeball it. We can also automate our devices based on these measurements, which is really cool. Growing mushrooms, you might also want a CO2 monitor. This is something we're working on at Felix Smart right now. We're developing a mushroom kit that will have all the probes and sensors you need to automate your system. But for right now, temperature and humidity is plenty good. I trust myself enough to know when CO2 levels are spiking, so I should be A-okay. With mushrooms, you want to keep a sterile environment, so I'm going to spray down all my tools and my environment before beginning. Now that everything is disinfected, I can actually start programming my devices with Kai. Blue oyster mushrooms like a cooler environment with higher humidity, so I will program everything accordingly. I'll start by putting my temperature and humidity sensor into the tent, because that's what I'm going to need to start programming my devices. So I will just feed this in down here, and I will put it as low as my mushrooms are gonna be growing at so that I can get a good idea of the conditions that they're gonna be experiencing. Right when I plug in my sensor to Kai, I can see them pop up into my app, and I'll just pin them on my front screen. So I can see right now the temp is around 21.9 degrees Celsius and humidity is 58.1, but I'm sure that will crank right up when we have the mushrooms in there. I'll just program this device to keep the humidity way up there. Turn on humidifier when my humidity is less than, let's go 86, I think is a good range for these blue oysters, 86.0, perfect. And then I will add another event on the high range to turn off my humidifier when my humidity is greater than, let's go 92, I think that's a good high range for these oyster mushrooms. That'll keep them in a nice humid environment. And I'll save that. I just plugged my lights into Kai, and I will add these as a device, and then I will program a timer on them. So I'll add light, I'll select that it is a light, and I will say I put them in socket number 5, because I did. Then I'll head over to timers, I'll add a timer. I'm going to start these at 6 a.m. and I will end them at 10 p.m. This will give the mushrooms 16 hours of light, which is what I want for these oyster mushrooms. We're also going to time lapse the whole process, and Kai makes that super easy, so we'll show you how that goes later. I just plugged my fan into Kai, and I'm going to add that as a device as well. So I'll hop in here, press fan, there we go, done, and I plugged that into socket number 2, so I'll save that. And then I'm going to program a cycle for my fan, where it turns on for 5 minutes every hour. So to do this, I'm gonna head in here, set it to 0, and for the start time, and then 24 nearly for the end time, all the way up to 59 there. And then I'm gonna repeat it 24 times a day. So there we go. So now for 5 minutes out of every hour, my fan will turn on. I'll just save that. And that'll continue to provide fresh air for the mushrooms so that they don't suffocate with all the CO2 in there. And we can vent out the spores into a better environment that's not our living room. We're gonna probably filter the end. Now that my tent is all set up, I can actually plop my blue oyster grow block into my tent and cut a slit in it in a bit of an X shape for my mushrooms to fruit out of. And that's all it takes to 100% automate your grow tent. Kai is a total game changer in the world of indoor cultivation. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like it as it really helps us out. Also subscribe to the channel, ask us any questions that you may have down below, or just send a good vibe our way, and I'll see you next time.